People that recycle laptop parts from broken laptops usually recycle the touchpad thing. But in many cases, even when the keyboard is broken and is replaced, the old keyboard is thrown away. However, there is one useful part in that keyboard that can be reused, which is the pointing stick. The pointing stick from Synaptics company is called TouchStyk, and this little device can be extracted and repurposed, for example, for connecting to Arduino. I'm going to show you how to find out the pinout for touchpads and pointing sticks and how to connect them to Arduino successfully. The example here is from Synaptics. So as you can see, I've already extracted it from the keyboard. That was a broken keyboard, and I've just extracted this thing, which was under some tape on the back of the keyboard. Let's have a look at how you can find out the pinout for such a little device, even though if you cannot find this specific part number on the internet. Actually, the method that I'm going to show you will help you to find out the pinout and connection points for any kind of touchpad or pointing stick, regardless of the manufacturer and regardless of whether there is pinouts existing on the internet. First thing that you need to do when you are trying to determine the pinout for your touchpad or the pointing stick is to find ground. The way to do this is to use the multimeter, and what you need to do is to find some contact where you can clearly see the base. For example, this just around the frame of the touch stick. I'm sure there is a contact to the ground on this one. And then continuously try out all the soldering points or the test points on the PCB. Okay, so this one, clearly not. This one, no. Okay. So this one, which is number 23 on old PCBs from Synaptics. There used to be a letter T before the numbers, but this has been removed in the newer models. For example, this model here, I estimated to be from around 2013. So number 23 is ground, and it's a good idea to start making some notes. Number 23, so this is ground. Next one that you need to find is the VCC or the power supply. These devices usually work with 5 volts, and you need to find the pin which corresponds to the 5 volts input. The trick to apply when you are looking for a power supply to such unit from any manufacturer is to look out for any pins which don't go directly to the chip, like all these connections here, but the pin which goes through some kind of a resistor and a capacitor. And as you can see here, there is a resistor here, and there is also a capacitor next to it, which is marked as C2. So I'm assuming that this capacitor is between the power supply and the ground. So let's check that as well. I'm gonna use the test point, the ground test point, which is 23, and test if indeed the ground is supplied to the capacitor. Okay, this side not. Okay, so this side is the ground supply, and that means this side is the ground contact, and this means that the other side is probably the 5 volt power supply. Now let's try to follow where this contact, the other contact from capacitor goes. So obviously it goes to resistor, and from resistor it goes to this point here. You can hear the sound even though there is a resistor, because the resistance is very low. So that point 22 is most likely to be the power supply point, and we can check which number of that pin that is on the connector. So the ground is pin 3 on the connector, and this one, pin 22, it's number 1. So these several signs hint that this most likely will be the power supply. So let's just mark that for the ease of use in the future when I'm going to be soldering the points. So this one, I think, is going to be 5 volts, because it goes to the resistor and then to the capacitor, and the other side of the capacitor is the ground contact. All the other points are going directly into the chip, so unlikely that they're going to be the power supply, because you need to have a resistor and a capacitor. And again, for convenience, I'm going to mark the pins also that I've already found out. So the first pin number 1, this is 5 volts, and the third pin is the ground. Next step you need to take is to solder the test wires so that you can connect this to the power supply or already to the Arduino and start looking for the other pins. The other pins that you need to find out are the two most important pins, the clock and also the data. Even though this is a 2013 unit, they are still using in Synaptics the PS2 protocol, so that's why you would need to look for clock and data pins. All the other pins are probably related to some kind of buttons or some additional functionality, but for the purpose of this video, I only care about the pointing stick itself, so the clock and the data, so that I can get the readings from when I'm moving the pointing stick. Now that I've soldered the power and ground, let's check the other contact pads and see which pins they correspond to. As we found out, pin number 1 is 5 volt and pin number 3 is ground, so most unlikely the pin in the middle is going to be either clock or data, so I'm going to skip this one. I'm going to test for the contact pads for this one, that's pin number 4 and pin number 5. Let's see what the contact pads are for these. Okay, so pin number 4. Pad 25, no. Terminal 6, no. Okay, so terminal 11. Pin number 4 is T11. What about pin number 5? Okay, so pin 5 is T10. I suspect that these two are going to be my data and clock pins. Let's solder some wires on the pin 10 and 11 on the PCB and connect all of these pins to the Arduino. Right, so terminal 10 is going to be green, this one over here, and terminal 11, this one over here, is going to be the white. Let's hook it up to Arduino, load the code and start testing. So I'm using a sample code provided by the Arduino CC website. The pins that are going to be used for data and clock connections are going to be pin number 5 and pin number 6 on the Arduino. Ground goes here, 5 volt. Even though I know that I need to connect my white and green to 5 and 6, I don't know the order in which I need to connect. So I'm just gonna do trial and error. First I go 6 white and green is gonna be 5. Let's load the sketch into the Arduino and see if serial monitor is giving any data. So as you can see, nothing is being sent to the output. So now I change and put green pin to pin number 6. And then white wire goes into pin number 5. And immediately, as you can see, I'm getting some readings. Now let's see if the pointing stick is working. I'm gonna reverse it and put it upside down so that I can test the pointing stick. And let's do some manipulations. Great. This is up, this is down, left, right. Perfect. Now that we've got the pointing stick working, let's change the code so that it's only outputting into serial monitor once there are proper readings, not just zeros. Great, so I'm not getting any readings unless I start moving the mouse. So that's it for today. As I mentioned, this is a great little device that I'm planning to use to build a small remote control with a mini joystick for my robot. Actually, I'll give you a hint. In 90% of the pinouts that I saw on the internet, the Synaptics devices all use the same pin numbering when it comes to the terminal sensor pins, these golden circles over here. 22 is always 5 volts, 23 is always ground, T10 is always clock, and T11 is always data. 90% of the pinouts that I saw on the internet have the same matching as I found out over here. In most of the cases, the same terminal numbers will apply to your device as well. And that's not only the pointing sticks, but also the touchpads. For example, if you disassemble the IBM keyboard, you will also find the pointing stick. It's also Synaptics, but if it's not, you can use the same principle to connect the pointing stick to Arduino. Thanks for watching, and if you found it useful, please click the like button below.